In the last video, we had our first example of cross-site scripting due to a shitty PHP app. But in the end, we fixed our PHP code by escaping the user-supplied string. But I got this code from this tutorial website, and that one is still burnable. So let's play around with that one. The code here is loaded in an iframe below. An iframe is like another web page embedded in this main web page. With right-click, we can investigate this iframe and, for example, display its source code. Now we also know the direct URL to this example. So last time we tried to put a script tag with alert into the name field, but when we do that, there will be no alert pop-up box and we get an error in the JavaScript console showing us that the Chrome XSS Auditor prevented the execution of it. The XSS Auditor is special to Chrome. Not every browser has such a protection. For example, Firefox does not have an equivalent and will happily execute the alert. But we want to dig deeper. We want to not give up because of something like this. So let's try to bypass the XSS Auditor for Chrome. In this case, we do not only have one get parameter that reflects input. In fact, there is a second one, the age parameter. And once there are multiple inputs, the XSS Auditor is basically broken. So we can try this to split up our XSS payload. The first parameter name will open the script tag and start the alert, but end at the quote. Now we expect a string. And for the age, we start with a quote, close the alert function parenthesis, and finally close the script tag. And when we submit this, we get an alert box displaying us BRUR. Let's see what happened. When we look at the HTML source, we can see that we simply wrap the text between the two outputs into a string and use it as a parameter for alert. And this is already enough to confuse the XSS Auditor. As soon as you have multiple injection points, you can try to get really creative to fool the XSS Auditor. Let's try to push this one step further and replace this first alert with something silent, so we can put an alert with our content afterwards. One way is to still wrap the text in quotes, but instead of using it as a parameter, we assign it to a variable a. And afterwards, we can still write our JavaScript code and do the alert with something we want. Okay, neat. In the last video, I briefly mentioned that there are different contexts for XSS, and each might come with its own challenges or tricks. So I made here a simple test PHP page where you can play around with some XSS attempts. So there's the normal HTML context where it simply echoes into the page, but then also two cases where the echo is inside of an attribute, one with quotes around, the other doesn't have quotes, and then a script context where the echo is inside of script tags. At the end I have a small little XSS Auditor trick, which is quite fun. Anyhow, so we basically covered the first injection already with the last video. So let's directly move on to the attribute context. The first one is handled with parameter B. Let's open this page in the source view so we can see the resulting HTML, which makes it easier to work with. The parameter B is currently XSS, which we can see got placed inside of the source attribute of this image. Theoretically, we could now set B to an image URL and we would get an image displayed. But can we also execute JavaScript here? Well, what we can try to do is inject a quote which would end this attribute, then we could inject a tag closing greater than sign, and then include a script tag. That looks good. That could work, but unfortunately the XSS Auditor caught this attempt as well. So this doesn't work in Chrome, but generally it would be in XSS, for example in Firefox. Also, the red highlighting makes it super cool to see if our attempts injected valid JavaScript, so that's cool. Would this work with HTML special chars, which we used last time to fix the code? We can test that with parameter BB. Nope, doesn't work. The double quote and the greater than sign get encoded, so this looks safe. But there is a third test. What about single quotes? Didn't work. No, wait. The single quote did not get encoded. Maybe we can still turn this into an XSS, we just can't use the greater than sign. Luckily, image tags have an event handler that fires if an image couldn't get loaded. This means we can inject an onError attribute that calls alert. And yeah, that worked. Chrome recognized the attempt of executing JavaScript. Awesome. So HTML special jars does not protect you in every case. For example, in the attribute context with single quotes, it's not enough. The PHP manual documents this. It says you have to specifically set the ENT quotes flag, otherwise single quotes are untouched. Another lessons learned in read the frickin' documentation. Let's move on to the next one. This one is easy. Like the previous example, we are in the attribute context. And now we even don't have to take care of quotes. So even if single quotes are escaped, you just simply don't use any quotes in the attributes. So the injection with onArrow works great with and without HTML special jars. Now the last example is the script tag context. This looks even more simple. Just write alert 1 and it should get executed. Looks good, but the XSS auditor did not catch this one. If we try this in the normal view, we trigger the XSS. And this obviously works despite HTML special jars. So these examples showed you that using HTML special jars is not enough every time. There are many places where things can go wrong. So be careful and be aware in what context you output user supplied strings. But now, what's up with those tricks down here? The first trick is just an example how somebody might try to prevent XSS. It replaces all occurrences of script. This means you cannot inject a script tag. There are two possibilities. First one is simply not using a script tag. For example, use the image payload we have seen above. An image tag with an onArrow attribute to fire an alert. Though the issue is that the XSS auditor catches that. But there's a way around it. We can use the lame attempt of XSS prevention by replacing script to our advantage. We can randomly place script inside of our image tag payload and the occurrences of script will be removed. And now the URL parameter does not resemble anything that is found on this page. Thus Chrome cannot guess that this parameter is responsible for this image tag here. So this bypasses the XSS auditor. The second trick here is fun. So first we have to understand this JavaScript code. First, a variable ASD is initialized and set to a value. And then this script checks if ASD exists. If the variable ASD does not exist, you would execute the alert. But how could you redirect code execution of this JavaScript so that it would execute this alert? I give you a second to think about this. Okay, here's the solution. We abuse the XSS auditor, who would have thought? We use a fake parameter with the first script as a value. Now Chrome thinks that this parameter is responsible for this script tag and will disable it, prevent its execution. Thus ASD never got initialized and we successfully redirect code execution to trigger the alert. We can see the alert popping up. Amazing, that's so cool.